I'm here with Brian from Code 8, the team from Uganda, and you guys have created a project called Matibabu. Tell me a little bit about this, because this is a really important project, I think.
Yeah, Matibabu is to diagnose for malaria without having to prick your body for any blood sample. It takes around 15 minutes for a normal diagnosis, and they pick a small blood sample, which may, at early stages, not be infected. But with Matibabu, we are going to diagnose a bloodstream for 60 seconds, which gives it more efficiency. In Africa, you may find a hospital has no power for 24 hours, and that means more children are dying, because a child dies every minute of malaria. But malaria is around affecting 160 countries, and in Africa, it's 91%. We are moving out to partner with associations like World Health Organization, so that we can plug into their distribution patterns and then put up a booth like in a village where everybody can have this accessible.
Can you operate it with minimal training, I'm guessing, right? Like anybody can use it?
No training. Yeah. No training. You just have to tap a button, which is absolutely no training.
So lead me through how Matibabu works.
All you need is such a small device, though this is still a prototype. That's why you see the adrenal board around it.
And so why are you using a light sensor? What happens when I put my finger in it?
The red blood cell is biconcave, and when it's affected by the malaria plasmodium, it affects the light scattering properties. Okay. So if I put a red light through your finger at different wavelength, I'm able to pick intensities and of the
So you're seeing, the red blood cell gets deformed, so light bounces off of it differently, and you guys are able to see that difference in scattering.
Actually, not only the shape, because the shape is one factor, but also the biochemical properties.
Awesome. And on a personal level, what made you want to tackle this?
Personally, I suffered from the disease for some good time, and during that moving, you reach a clinic, no power, so they can't diagnose you. You move to the other, they have to prick every time, and they take a sample, and they say, We are not sure it's malaria. You go back home, you come back, you're still feeling not good, and then they keep on doing the same thing.
You could spend a day, 2 days, just traveling from clinic to clinic trying to get properly diagnosed.
Yeah, that's true.
So you're using some off-the-shelf parts here. How inexpensive do you picture Matibabu being?
Actually, it won't be higher than $20.
So tell me about, coming from Uganda, creating this thing, to the Imagine Cup.
Wow, it's great. You sometimes come and say, you're in St. Petersburg, Imagine Cup, the finals. It's really great experience.
Tell me about the tech scene in Uganda. Are there a lot of people who are doing things like this, computer engineering?
It's pretty hard because it's a new field in Uganda, but we are trying hard to pull up, supporting ourselves. Microsoft has innovation centers, for example, Microsoft Innovation Centers and other hubs and other technological hubs down planted there. So With assistance from those, we are fighting hard to see that we develop the industry in Uganda.
So cool. So if people want to find out more about this, if they want to know about Matibabu, how it maybe help out in some way, how can they do it?
Actually, we have a blog. It's matibabu.blog.com. And you can find us on Facebook at Matibabu and Twitter at MatibabuAIDS.
Thank you so much, Brian.
Thank you.
Yeah,
thank you.
Best of luck to you today.
Thank you.
Remember, guys, we have tons more from Imagine Cup all week. There are some brilliant innovations here on the floor, including some games. If you want to see those are over at the Rev3 Games site, youtube.com/Rev3 Games. And be sure to subscribe here for more from the Imagine Cup.